What's going on, Atlanta? This is Peter Mack, the local joker, coming back in with you all. This is the first time I've talked to y'all since last year. I hope everything's been good with y'all. I hope y'all had a wonderful new year. Everybody was safe and sober. If you weren't sober, I hope you had a driver to get you to your destination, because DUIs are hell to pay off. Okay, first of all, I want to say this. This is what I want to see happen in 2013. I want to see some of this unnecessary stuff just stop. Like, first unnecessary thing, I want some of these unnecessary terms to die down in 2013. Number one is being swag. Oh my goodness, we didn't overuse swag so much. Swagoo, swaggerific, swag surfing. It just needs to die down. You remember back in the day when the quote unquote other element would determine if a term would go out of style? We don't even have to wait for the quote unquote other element anymore, because we didn't kill this word. This one word that needs to go, gone. Vini Vini Vici, just bye bye.
He said Vini
Vini Vici. Vini Vini Vici, yes, going, going, gone. And magician, I don't know what language I call a magician. Also want some of this stuff on social media to die down as well. Like, a lot of this foolishness, the number one foolishness I hate on social media is when you see some of these girls, they put up these ultra-religious statuses. Jesus has been so good to me. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want all this. The next picture, you see them with a black tight dress that come on about 5 inches above their waist with a strawberry margarita in their hand. They look like they didn't already have about 4 or 5 of them. They in club, Onyx or whatnot. But you want me to expect that you are real holy and religified. And there's some other pictures they have. They do some stuff that's so bad. It's probably got Satan going, that's a damn shame. What is wrong with you? That is just horrible. And other things I want people to stop doing, like with these memes. Is it memes or memes? How you pronounce when people take pictures and they put like crazy sayings and stuff on it? How's it pronounced? M-E-M-E. Was it meme? Meme? You know what I'm talking about. Like, they'll take like Rudy from The Cosby Show or Michelle from Full House, as cute as she is, and put up real vulgar statuses or stuff. But then want to wonder why they can't get no job.
Right.
They're hating them. No, you're putting up obscene things on your Facebook wall. Who is gonna hire you for their marketing consulting company? Nobody. What is wrong with you? And another thing I want people to do, Instagram. Instagram was used to document like pictures you're having fun and all that. It wasn't meant for you to take pictures of inanimate objects. I'm so sick of people taking pictures of their accessories, like the shoes and other jewelry and stuff, didn't wonder why somebody robbed them.
Instagram them made instant photographer.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody think they Garden Parks and all that. And for those who don't know, Garden Parks is a very famous black photographer. Don't sit there. And that's right, I'm teaching. You're going to learn something else besides foolishness today from Peter Mack. And I actually hate when people what is the purpose of taking pictures of your food? Who does that? Who has time to take pictures of their food? Y'all never seen that on Instagram?
Yeah, but that was something I think I was about to start doing.
Why would you take a picture of your food?
I feel everybody.
You be proud of your plate.
Yeah, maybe you made the meal. It's like, man, that looks good.
Well, it's not even a meal. Sometimes people will take a picture. A straight grubbing. You got a McDonald's Big Mac. What is so special about a Big Mac? I know I've made them. I used to work at McDonald's High School. There's nothing special about McDonald's.
No, I'm talking about home cooked meals. Yeah. Right.
When I say home cooked meals, I ain't gonna lie, because that's been a determining factor on some women I date. This I cook. Oh, well, hey girl, how you doing? You know, it's a good play, girl. You bad as all. I let a player play. Mess with me, man. And I'm gonna say this, I'm kind of being kind of short. I was pressed for time when I made this. But in 2013, I want this to stop. Now, we are in the city of Atlanta. As everybody know, Atlanta has a lot of people who are, you know, of the LGBT
community.
Yeah. I want people to stop doing this, especially all my black men. Stop being so scared of gay men. Because I'm going to tell you something. 9 times out of 10, they're not really even thinking about you. 9 times out of 10. And then, 2, you're blocking yourself away from a lot of opportunities. As men, it's 10 to 1 women, and you worry about a man who don't like women? What is going on with you? Like, I hate to hear people say this right here. I don't go to Onyx because they got a lot of them boys in there. They got a lot of women in Onyx. I mean, not Onyx, Lenox. I don't go to Lenox Mall because they got a lot of gay dudes in there. They also got a lot of beautiful women going to Lenox, too. Let me tell y'all something. I actually get happy when I see a gay dude in Atlanta. I'm like, woo, yes. My time is going up. Thank you, Jesus. Because I like the fact there's a lot of gay men in Atlanta. For one reason, women already outrank men 10 to 1. Since they like dudes at 20 to 1, I don't have that much game. I need every advantage I can get. I'm just being honest.
And then two,
this is another thing. Sometimes, hey, gay men are friendly. I'm not saying like friendly, like flirty. Sometimes they can be a little friendly. Because I remember one time I was in the club. you gotta remember, I'm from Mississippi. I just moved here about a month or so. It was a month or so after I moved here. I'm still kind of green, you know. So I'm just sitting there talking. I'm thinking, he talking, because you know we are in the South. Yeah. We're very hospitable. Then he offered to buy me a drink, and I thought about it. Wait a minute, this is Atlanta. This gay man might be offering to buy me a drink. He might think he tried to flirt with me. But he said, you give everyone. I took that Patron, though. I took it, though. It was a shot of Patron. I took, hey, it's a free drink. Don't judge me.
Don't you judge me.
It's a free drink. I had to do what I had to do, man. Don't. Y'all got judgment written all on y'all face in the studio. I don't like it. I don't like it at all.
I ain't said that. Nobody
and for the last, and in 2013, I know I've been talking about this 2012. I really want them to bring Twinkies back. Come on, man. Just bring the Twinkies back, please, man. I mean, man, I got $100 on bringing Twinkies back. Man, we all pull $100 together. We can bring Twinkies back, and this could be good.
Twinkie Gate.
Come on, just bring Twinkie back. And then I'm going to say this by 2013. I said this in 2012. Stop popping them mollies. Stop popping them mollies. They killing y'all. No pun intended. They really killing y'all. And it don't make you look cool. Because if you ever see somebody on molly, they swear they look cool. You look like a fool. But that's been my own time. That's all the things I want to see happen in 2013. This has been your boy, the local joker, Petey Mac. You can follow me on Twitter at PeteyMac89. That is PeteyMac 89. And now we're going to get back to the rest of Ferocious Friday. And the Joker is out.